In this tutorial, we'll show you how to configure, use, and disable a proxy server on Google Chrome. We'll walk you through a process both on Windows and Mac. Just choose a timestamp. But why would you want to configure proxy settings on Chrome? A proxy server acts as an intermediary between your computer and the internet. It can help you change your IP address to browse anonymously or access content that's not available in your location. The proxy server feature in Google Chrome is disabled by default. If it's enabled without your knowledge, that might mean you're on a school or business network or have malware on your device. In any case, here's how to enable and disable a proxy server on Chrome. If you're using Chrome for Windows, open the Chrome menu in the upper right corner of your browser. Click on Settings. Click on Advanced and open System. In System, select Open your computer's proxy settings. You should get the proxy settings displayed on your screen. If not, you probably have an older version of Windows, so skip to this timestamp. But if you do see the proxy settings, go under Automatic Proxy Setup, toggle Automatically Detect Settings off if you want to disable proxy settings, and toggle it on if you want to enable proxies. This toggle allows Windows to automatically detect proxy settings from your business or school network. If your computer isn't connected to one, you'll want to keep it off. If you're not on a managed network, toggle Manual Proxy Setup on, then enter the proxy server's IP address and port. The IP and port will be provided by a proxy provider. Finally, click Save. If you want to disable proxies, go under Manual Proxy Setup and toggle User Proxy Server Setting off. If you have an older Windows version, let's say Windows 7, when you go to Chrome menu, click on Settings, Advanced, System, and then select Open your computer's proxy settings. It will direct you to Internet Properties. Once there, click on the Connections tab and open LAN Settings. To enable proxies, do this. If your computer is part of a school or business network, check the box that says Automatically Detect Settings. This will allow Windows to automatically detect any proxy settings that are configured for the whole computer network in your institution. If you aren't connected to any network, simply leave the box unchecked. Instead, check the box Use your proxy server for your LAN. Enter the proxy server's IP and port and click OK. By doing this, you've connected to your proxy server manually. If you want to disable proxies, simply uncheck the boxes Automatically Detect Settings and Use your proxy server for your LAN and click OK. If you're on Mac, open the Chrome menu in the upper right corner of your browser. Click on Settings, click on Advanced and open System. In System, select Open your computer's proxy settings. A window will appear where you'll find a list of proxies. If you want to start using proxies, then select the proxy type you have, enter the server's IP address and port in the fields on the right, and click OK. You might be asked to enter your Mac user password as well. Do so and click Allow. Finally, press Apply. If you want to disable proxies, uncheck all the boxes in the proxy list, press OK, and then Apply. And then, go back to YouTube and subscribe to our channel for more tutorials like this and useful proxy reviews. As you've likely noticed, if you need to use proxies often and then disable them after each use, this might be quite a hassle. Therefore, developers have created their own Chrome extensions to make this process quicker. For example, there's Foxy Proxy or Switchy Omega. The same goes for some proxy providers like GeoSurf and Smart Proxy. Would you download an extension to avoid this whole process? If yes, give this video a thumbs up to let us know. It's interesting to see how many of you would prefer an extension. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video about Instagram proxies.